The next presentation is by Ms. G. Gunawardena. She is from International College for Business and Technology in Sri Lanka. The title of the presentation is Exploration of Factors Affecting Happiness of Sri Lankans. I'm sure this is going to be a very interesting presentation. Ms. Gunawardena.
Good morning, everyone. This research is about how happy our Sri Lankans are. If you go back to the introduction, in the present world, the world is moving away from measuring the development of a country by looking at the gross domestic production, that is a GDP, or the gross national production, that is GNP. The latest concept in the world is looking at the development of a country by measuring how happy the people of those countries are. Because the psychologists and the development experts believe today that if a country needs to achieve what is called a sustainable development, in Sri Lanka also we keep on talking about sustainable development today. If you want to achieve sustainable development, that the people of the country has to be happy, or if you take it as a multidimensional measure, okay, the people has to be happy in their lives. So that's the latest concept. Actually, this concept has been developed first. It has been originated in Bhutan. As we all know, Bhutan is a country which is originated in Buddhism. It's a Buddhist country. And this concept is also based on the Buddhist concepts that the people has to be happy. And the Center for Bhutan Studies, actually it has been developed and it has been introduced in the first place as far as in 1972. But they have given their proper study and they have published their studies in 2012. And they have developed something called the Gross National Happiness Index for Bhutan, where they measure all the multidimensional measurements of subjective well-being. I'll touch on what the subjective well-being is. They believe that the people are happy as long as they do better than their neighbors. That's what you mean by subjective well-being. Like, you know, you compare yourself always to the people who are next to you. Okay, so the subjective well-being also has been taken into consideration in measuring the happiness of the people. Taking this concept further, in United Nations, that is UN, has already declared 20th of March as the International Day for Happiness. And this particular day has marked its second anniversary very recently. The problem is the report which has been published by the United Nations, the latest report was based on the data which has been collected during the period 2010 to 2012. And among several countries, that is 156 countries which they have measured, Sri Lanka is ranked 137, quite low. Okay. We are quite low. So, United Nations has taken a combination of higher life expectancy, gross domestic product per capita, generosity, freedom to make life choices, and the perception of corruption in consideration in ranking these countries. Okay. So there is a significant drop if you compare this report from the previous report, which has been based on the 2005 to 2010 data. Sri Lanka's position has actually dropped. So this study aims to fill this gap in knowledge as to why the Sri Lankans are not happy, because I was not able to find any particular studies which are addressing the Sri Lankan concept, saying how happy the Sri Lankans are or what are the factors which are affecting the happiness levels of Sri Lankans. When you go through the happiness studies, it is evident that this happiness concept is always culturally based, because most of the studies are Western oriented, because the people in the Western countries have different values than us, so the reasons why they could be happy are generally different from the reasons why we could be happy. So the studies which has been based on different countries have come up with different factors. So that's why I decided to address the question through this research, what are the factors affecting the happiness levels of Sri Lankans. So if we go back to the theoretical background, most of the literature on happiness studies are based on the Western individualistic societies. There are a few main literature which are based on the Eastern societies, which are based on Bhutan, Japan, China, and Hong Kong, as well as Taiwan and all those countries have done some researchers. And this is a summary of the literature. There are several writers like Alcott Foster and Campbell and all those people who have studied and they have developed an index for the countries in order to measure the happiness level of these people. And if we look at the happiness level of countries, the in the world, always the Scandinavian countries led by Denmark are leading the happiness levels of the world. If we go back to the methodology and study design, there is a qualitative approach and an inductive study design has been utilized. And I have chosen the population from Colombo, Gampa and Kalutara districts of Sri Lanka, and the sample size has been decided according to the Morgan table with a confidence level of 95%. And the convenient sampling has been adopted, and the Sri Lankans between the age of 21 to 60 has been chosen as the sample, and they are the people who have lived their entire life in Sri Lanka. So that is that was to make sure that they share the same cultural values, so that the factors which we identify through the study will be unique to Sri Lanka. So the interviews were conducted at a place of convenience for the respondents, and there was no time limit was set. And the respondents were interviewed on a structured interview, basically asking the question, what makes you happy? When we analyze these results, it was analyzed using a thematic approach. And when we analyze, there were 12 themes which emerged as the things which make the Sri Lankans happy. Among them, family was ranked first, where it scored 74%, and career, wealth, self-growth, freedom, self-autonomy, interpersonal and social relationships, absence from the negative feelings, recreation needs, health, education, religious and spiritual needs, national prosperity, and surprisingly, the basic physiological needs came last. It scored only 4%. And at this level, I guess when we take into consideration the promotion of sustainable development, preservation and promotion of the cultural value, conservation of natural environment, and establishment of good governance, this concept has gone beyond the Buddhist ideas and now it has become an internationally recognized framework. Now, when we go for the conclusion, the outcome of the study has identified 12 factors which are affecting the happiness of the Sri Lankans. And the findings of this study is in par with several studies which has been done previously. And among these factors, family was reported to have the highest score. And this has this study is in par with generally the studies which has been done in the Eastern culture, where we put the socialist value, that is our family values first. And there are certain limitations for my study as well, because this present study was just a beginning of developing a happiness index for Sri Lanka, and it has been just based on only three districts of the country. And if you really want to develop happiness index which is applicable for the entire Sri Lanka, we will have to include more sample covering the entire country. So that is a main limitation which I had in my study. Thank you.